Hey, Chief.
What do you want, son? If it's car cleaning you're after, forget it. It's only the muck that holds some of these together.
I'm looking for some wheels.
Leasey Street, round the corner. Big toy shop full of skateboards. If you wait till 1 o'clock, the bloke goes for his dinner and the lot's rubbish.
Hey, Cyril, I've just had that Mr. Prendergast on the phone again.
The bloke who bought the Avenger?
He said you swore to him it was a good little runner.
No, Wes. He minds him. My exact words was, it would suit a good little runner.
Do you mind, only I'm trying to buy a car, Amy.
Son, just because you've been drinking in pubs since you was 12 doesn't mean to say you're old enough to sign a false name to an HP document.
Don't want HP. I'm paying cash for the right motor.
You've come to the right place, son. Who recommended us? Your probation officer, was he?
What do you think I am, no oldies? The old fella on a pool syndicate for years.
And they come up on it, did they?
No. We never sent the goopins in. So when you snuffed it like it all come to me.
They are, Cyril. See, if your socialist lot was in power, death duties would have crippled this youth.
Yeah, son. Ideal first car, this. Defeat the joyriders. This town's full of them. You can leave this one parked anywhere. Leave the keys in the ignition if you want.
I want the Jag.
Son, Bruce Grobbelaar has put his marker on this one. Asked us to save it for him. But there you are. If he's let it slip through his fingers, why should you worry?
Does it really go?
What? This motor? Does it go? Tell him, Cyril.
Son, it's only the owner of a car like this who knows the true meaning of the word horsepower.
I want a test drive.
Well, we'll have to check the batteries.
Yeah, well, that's okay, because I can't stop right now any road. And I'm late for the accountants as it is. Following Adam being fitted for the suit, and well, then I've got to go and look at a bungalow in West Kirby. It's nice over the water, isn't it? No, I can't stop right now. The only time I can make it is 9:45 tonight.
Grace, beer waiting for you. Would you like to leave a deposit on it?
Yeah, well, if I don't like that to the test drive, I certainly will.
Cyril, you cannot give him or anybody else a test drive in this.
I've got it all worked out. I've got this route starting at the pitch, ending at the pitch, downhill all the way.
Cyril!
Don't knock it, Wes. This route is the fruit of years of cogitation. All right, there's one uphill, Derby dies. But if I can get a good run at it, time the lights proper, I can make this car look like a real goer. Honest.
Be honest with me, Mrs. McGregor. Am I losing me looks?
You look the same to me, Glenys, as when you first got engaged to our Cyril.
But that's 6 years ago. I'm not getting any younger. And I want to start a family, but not till we're married, like.
Oh, you're right, love. Do it proper. Get yourself a house full of furniture before you start having kids. Don't be like me. Do you know, I'd had a pram 3 years before I saw a second light of a wardrobe.
I'm not blaming Cyril, but this divorce of his is taking a long time. Do you know how it's going on?
Well, all I can tell you is he's never out of that solicitor's office. Honest, Glenys, before our Cyril got going, I thought legal aid was a soft drink.
Sometimes you wonder at men, don't you? I keep asking myself, does he think of me just as a plaything?
Ah, oh, no, love. Far as I can tell, what's dragging it out is the maintenance. Because she's got a very good job, you see. But I've told him, Cyril, you don't want her money. Just take your freedom. He's like his dad when it comes to money. Now, his dad, he used to go walking along the Scotty Road, never took his eyes off the ground. He used to say it's amazing how much small change rolls into the tram lines. It was half a crown he was trying to prize up when the tram hit him. If it had been a shilling, he'd probably have had it up and been gone.
Hi, ma'am.
Hiya, ma'am.
I've got nothing for your tea.
Well, didn't you bring nothing back from the cafe?
Look, I'm sick of smuggling stuff home for you two to turn your noses up at. I'm trusted in that cafe. Anyway, we had the health inspector in today, and if you'd heard what he had to say... Now, let me have a root ground in the kitchen.
And you're speaking, Cyril. Doesn't your fiancé even get a kiss?
Can't trust myself with you, can I? I give you one kiss, passion sweeps over me. I hurl you to the floor,
Me mum's shot, and our Wesley doesn't know where to look.
You're a smooth talker, you.
I know. What are you doing here, any Rose?
Came round for a chat with your mum. Anyway, you thought you could give us a lift to work, and we can talk about your divorce and everything.
I won't have a lot of time for talking tonight, love. A bit of business, you know. I'll be popping out to the club for an hour. You can cover for me, can't you?
Nigel, a word. That party of insurance men last night, you chucked them out at the very first sign of trouble. Granted, they tore Faye's bodies, but it was good for another two rounds before there was so much of a window broke. There's many a club gone to the wall through the premature ejaculation of the boisterous Big Spender. It's a fine line, Nigel.
Evening, Mr. Stanley.
Evening, Glennis.
Hello there, Mr. Stanley.
What time do you call this, Cyril?
Time after time, I call myself that I'm so lucky.
All right. All right. Soon as the muscles arrive, Glennis, I'll give you the float.
Hey, Mr. Stanley, you know around the side of the dance floor? At Faye's end of the bar there? With all the flocks coming off the wall? You know, near the bloodstain. What you need there
is... Cyril, all I'm buying off you is a night's work. And if Nigel has any more trouble like last night, I don't want to find you lurking in a lady's lap again.
I was checking the windows, stopping any enforcement's getting in.
Have you seen the blood blisters on Nigel's knuckles? Oh, Nigel, you've dented your signet ring and all.
Yeah, but Nigel is a bouncer, pure and simple. I am a singer, stroke bouncer.
Bouncer, stroke singer.
But either way, oh, when do I get to sing?
You can have a spot tonight.
Great. Hey, I'll do me homage to Sinatra medley. Up at the Gattaca Yacht Haven, they call me Old Blue Eyes.
I heard it was Old Black Eyes.
I can do 50 minutes. 50 minutes without stopping to blow me nose.
You'll do two numbers at 10 past 10, piano only. Your function is to drive the punters towards the bar. Right then, I'll see if Faye's got everything she wants.
Hey, Cyril, you've got your own spot.
This is it, baby. You'll be able to say, Glennis, you was there when a star was born. You'll be able to tell your grandchildren, I seen Cyril McGregor on that legendary night at the Blue Cockatoo.
You'll be your grandchildren as well, Cyril.
Hey? Oh, yeah, yeah. Listen, I've got to give this punter his test drive. I'll see you later. Hey, Nigel, if old Stanley's looking for me, I'm just touring the perimeter wire. Oh, you could tell him. Tell you what, just use your initiative.
They were great, them faggots, ma'am.
I was lucky to get them, really. Because it was a real fracas at Speedy Save. Oh. I'm standing in the checkout queue, and this woman in front of me went spark out. Just like that, on the floor. They undid her blouse and everything, saying, give her air, like. She had this great big hat on. And when they took it off, she'd a frozen chicken on her head. She'd been standing there in the checkout queue with a frozen chicken on her head. Well, it must have chilled her brain.
It just goes to show you, ma'am, frozen food can be a hazard to your health.
Oh, I forgot to tell you, there's a letter for you behind the clock. It's got a foreign stamp on it.
It's from the Vatican, this stamp. It's me reply from the Pope.
When I turned for Cyril's dad, I never got no letter off the Pope. Never got nothing. Only a catechism off Father Boylan. And our Cyril, of course.
Well, the Pope doesn't write to you unless you write to him, ma'am.
Oh, yes, you can write to the Pope, can't you? But when you went to Pathelli, you never sent me so much as a card, me, your own mother. What did you say to him, anyway?
Well, I told him how much the, Confederation of Black Industrialists, of which I have the honour to be president, appreciated all the efforts he was making for world peace, like, and that next time he found himself in the area, we at Rathbone Motors would be delighted to quote him for a Pope mobile.
The Pope won't be coming round here no more. He's been once, he's seen it. Anyway, if he was going to come again, he'd have come for the garden festival, wouldn't he?
I know that, ma'am. I mean, to be honest, we'd be a bit stuck getting hold of a Pope mobile, wouldn't we? No, the important thing is, he's got the name in his head now. Rathbone Motors. And if he puts it round to his mates, like...
What does he say, then?
Dear Mr. McGregor, His Holiness directs me to thank you for your Confederation's expression of amity and goodwill. The blessing of Jesus Christ be ever with you. Yours faithfully, Monsignor G. Patelli.
I bet they say that to everybody.
P.S. About the Popemobile. It would have to have central door locking, as when he was in Toxteth last time, he had it broken into and all his samples nicked.
Yeah. He never said that.
All right, I made that up.
Just stop round here, will you?
What? Here? On a hill?
I said stop here!
The brakes are a bit keen, like. In fact, so keen we might have a bit of trouble getting off again. Look, son, if you want to talk money, let's go back to the pitch. There's people around here, I don't want to see me just now, you know.
Hey, don't stop the engine.
Oh, I didn't. That is your automatic cutout. Big saving on juice.
Get off!
Haven't you got the money?
Have you seen the bouncer in there? Size of the bus. You said the bouncer was only a little runt.
Hey, son, who are you calling a runt?
Shut up, you can drive.
All right, lads, what's going on?
You're our getaway driver. Now, will you start getting away?
God! I mean, if you told me sooner, I could have swung around and parked facing downhill.
And you were trying to sell me this heat.
Why can't you just nick a getaway car like everyone else?
I can't drive, that's why. You opportunity training scheme don't teach you nothing.
There they are! Cyril!
Looking very bad, Cyril. I mean, they got you at the scene of the crime.
Attempted crime. Them lads never got away with nothing.
Good point in mitigation. Still, you were driving the car that was used in the getaway.
Attempted getaway.
True. Aye. Still, Cyril, you must realise that as far as the case for the defence is concerned, on this occasion we can't pin our hopes on an alibi.
Honest, I never knew I was the getaway driver. Not until they got in the motor and told me they couldn't drive. On my mother's grave.
How is your man, by the way?
Never better, Mr. Coxter. Oh, remiss of me not asking. How's Angela?
The wife wants me to send her to a finishing school in Switzerland. Oh, I'm expected to do that on legal aid, eh? Now, look, Cyril, I've had a word with Inspector Pike, and as you know, there's been a bit of a crime explosion around about here. So if you will agree to 28 all the cases being taken into consideration, it's 6 months top, put out in four.
I'm innocent! I mean, really innocent? In fact, I'm a victim. You should be doing them scuffers for wrongful arrest, police harassment, assault while in custody. And we could do them for loss of earnings. Because I was booked to sing last night at the Blue Cockatoo.
Well, I've got enough of your litigation on my desk as it is. I mean, that case of yours against Hollywood superstars, Brackett's Wallacey, I mean...
I was hailed from that stage whilst singing Strangers in the Night, thereby sustaining injuries and contusions. If I'd have been singing a more up-tempo number, I'd have had my eyes open. I'd have seen him coming. And it's no good him saying it was a case of mistaken identity. He was the fellow that booked me.
I don't want to upset you, Cyril, but it's just possible that we are dealing with a man of straw. The last I heard, your assailant was running a fast food kiosk in Trestratton.
Oh, by the way, Mr. Cox, if you should have occasion to cross-examine my fiancée during this current unpleasantness, don't mention me divorce came through, all right?
You haven't told her?
Well, you know, been waiting for a suitable moment to break the good news.
You mean to tell me that in 18 months a suitable moment has not presented? All right, Cyril, leave it to me. I'll do my best.
What about bail?
Bail? I'll tell the wife that one.
Oh, hello, Dolly. Very sad morning, this.
Oh, God, Colwyn, it's bad enough them trying to rob you, but do they have to break the place up?
What, this? Oh, no. This was a bunch of girls we had in from Vernon's. One of them was getting married.
You know why I've come, Colwyn.
Dolly, it's no use appealing to me better nature. I haven't got one.
I've got memories tell me different. I know that underneath you're just a little boy lost.
Look, Dolly, I've already told the police what happened. Your Cyril sat out there in the getaway car.
You wouldn't testify against him, Colwyn. Give him another chance.
I'll give him every chance. I give him a job as a bouncer, at which he's hopeless.
Well, it's his chest. He's always had a weak chest.
I'm paying him to put out troublemakers. He can't even put the cat out if he doesn't want to go. The other night, it turned on him, had him on his back.
I know the law, son. My brother has the right to make a phone call. Well, if he had, I'd be the bloke he would have rang. So I'm saving you the price of a call by coming down here. Look, I don't think you know who I am. Wesley McGregor, chairman of the CBI, Confederation of Black Industrialists, and a personal pen friend of the Pope, also Ian Paisley, and not many people can say that. Do you want to see a letter from either of them, eh?
What do you want?
Justice.
This is a police station, sir.
Well, I am not leaving here without my brother, who you have got locked up down here in custody.
You're wrong, Chief. We've got nobody at the moment from your end of the shade, Colwyn.
I'm talking about Cyril McGregor. He's me brother.
Don't give me all the politics, sunshine. I've had all this brotherhood of mangsters. And there are three classes not included. One, scousers. Two, scuffers. Three, scouse scuffers. Now, up it.
Look, Cyril McGregor is my brother. If you don't believe me, go and ask me, ma'am.
Hey, McGregor, have you got a brother?
Yes.
What colour is it?
Black as a scuffer's heart.
And proud of it.
Well, I wouldn't have believed it if I hadn't seen it in black and white. All right, on your bike.
Have you stood me bail, Wes?
Bail my backside. We're not charging you. The boys in the vehicle section have gone over your pink jag. And according to the CID, if we charge you, you've got a cast iron defence.
What's that?
Insanity. Anybody using that heap as a getaway car can't be in the right mind. Now, clear off.
Great. Let's go, Wes.
Hang on. Hang on. Look, if this gets out, it's very bad for the firm. I mean, that's one of our top cars, that is. I mean, how's it going to look if it gets in the Echo? Police allege getaway car would not get away.
See what you mean? Looks bad, doesn't it?
Right, yeah. See, the thing is, Cyril, is if you plead guilty, it'll help me shift the car, definitely.
Get nothing!
All right, Sergeant. But if a word of this gets out, you will be hearing from my solicitor, Lord Goodman. And a letter from him frightens me. And I am one of his pen pals.
And you will be hearing from us. Failure to produce a valid MOT certificate.
MOT certificate? How many do you want?
Unroadworthy vehicle, defective brakes, no backlights, three bald tyres.
You mean one of them tyres was all right?
That's what we said in the ad, isn't it? Very genuine car for year. One careful owner.
Pity the other five weren't so careful.
On your way. And if I was you two, I wouldn't linger on any zebra crossings.
You know what means more to me than anything, Mr. Stanley? Even more than walking out of that police station a free man. It's known that you never doubted my innocence.
Let's just forget it, Cyril. Let's just call it a good idea gone to waste.
And by the way, as a personal tribute to you, I shall be singing My Way.
You will give him the build-up, won't you, Mr. Stanley? I mean, he's very nervous. He's had about 24 hours.
Don't fret, son. You're talking to a fellow what's introduced the best. And now the worst.
Breathing exercises, Cyril. Fill your lungs and don't do your Barry Manilow skip.
That is my skip. He stole that off me.
It doesn't matter. You know what you like once your nose starts bleeding.
I've just got to nip the gents.
Hello, Blue Cockatoo.
Right then, ladies and gentlemen, an extra treat for you now, and remember where you heard them first. Yeah. In a minute, I'm going to ask you to put your hands together for Liverpool's very own heartthrob. That's right, Cyril McGregor. Give the sod a chance. You only have to listen to him, I have to pay him. And while he's on, you'll find there's still some hot pies left. And Fabian the Barder is always at your service and eager to please. Right, I give you the one and only, your friend and mine, Cyril, the voice. Oh. Hang on. I've just been handed a very important emergency message, which might be of interest to some of you married ladies what might feel the need to get home quick. Ford's Halewood night shift have just gone out on strike.
Can you announce me yet?
Just one minute.